Good evening, dear viewers. Tonight on the News Hour, I bring to you the most alarming news break in recent times. A chilling intel alert accessed by Times Now, which reveals the death threat to Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Sensational details accessed by internal security editor Nikunj Garg will stun the nation tonight. Also on the News Hour tonight, a lobby is working overtime to gag Times Now from reporting the Sushant Singh mystery death case. I would like to assure all fans of Sushant Singh Rajput and this lobby that we won't back off. We will report, investigate and probe till we get justice for Sushant. But first up, ladies and gentlemen, in a chilling intel communication accessed by Times Now, the NIA has unearthed a plot against Prime Minister Narendra Modi. The three-word communication through an email that landed on the NIA's email in Mumbai came from a fake kind of an email address which says ylalwani12345@gmail.com, clearly a fake anonymous email, and which says just three chilling words: kill Narendra Modi. The threat against Prime Minister is a credible one and now has the attention of at least three security agencies. Sources have told your channel that this email originated somewhere outside of India. The NIA is suspecting a Pakistan-backed plot to target VVIPs, including the Prime Minister. The NIA, the Home Ministry and the Prime Minister's Special Protection Group are all coordinating with each other and other agencies. Now, what emboldens these assassins lying in the wait of a strike? Some would say that it is the politics of hate and name-calling against the Prime Minister that emboldens such plots. Right from 2007, when Prime Minister Narendra Modi, at that time the Chief Minister of Gujarat, the venom spewing politics that had begun. Listen in to at that time what Sonia Gandhi had called the Prime Minister, and this is what the Prime Minister Narendra Modi said to me in an interview during the elections of 2007 in Gujarat. And mainstream politicians who have been continuously using inflammatory language to target Modi and possibly incite these assassins who are possibly planning to take advantage of the fault lines of the divisions within India. Listen.
बताइए हैं कि आज गुजरात की सरकार चलाने वाले झूठे बेईमानी डर और मौत के सौदागर हैं।
गुजरात की धरती पर पहली सभा में मुझे मौत के सौदागर के रूप में जब उन्होंने ललकारा, तो लोकतंत्र में ये मेरा अधिकार बनता है, ये मेरा दायित्व बनता है कि जनता के पास सत्य पहुंचाना चाहिए। और मैं आज फिर से कहता हूं, अगर कांग्रेस पार्टी जिस मुद्दों पर चर्चा करेगी, मैं उसका उन्हीं की भाषा में जवाब दूंगा।
आप हम मुझसे चाहते हो, मैं हम नहीं कह रहा हूं, मैं कह रहा हूं मुझसे चाहते हो, वो मैं देने को तैयार हूं, और जो भी कुर्बानियां देनी हो उसमें मैं भी शामिल होने को तैयार हूं। अब देखें कि किसके हाथ कौन कौन किसका हाथ मजबूत है, हमारा या वो काफिर।
अभी तो सिर्फ शेरनियां बाहर निकली है और तुम्हारे पसीने छूट गए, और समझ लो अगर हम लोग साथ में आ गए तो क्या होएगा। 15 करोड़ है मगर 100 के ऊपर भारी है, याद रख लेना ये बात।
वो गुजरात समझ रहा है, 4% मुसलमान है गुजरात में, यहाँ 42% मुसलमान है, यहाँ गुजरात बना देगा, दादी की रोटी काट देंगे, दूसरी छोटी।
And I'm going across to Nikunj Garg, our internal security editor, who's accessed this mail and the NIA's warning that's gone out to North Block, where the Home Ministry is headquartered. And Nikunj, clearly these are agencies outside of India which are trying to take advantage of this hate campaign against the Prime Minister, even though there might be very few people who belong to this lobby, but the fact is they try to give the picture of a divided India when actually the majority of people have chosen Prime Minister not once, but twice, and with an extended support of the people.
Well, absolutely, Navika. There is no doubt about it. Even if you see the Bharatiya Janata Party's performance under Mr. Modi, the minority contribution to that performance is unrivaled, unparalleled in the history of independent India and in the history of the Bharatiya Janata Party. Having said that, the assessment till the point that I can be privy to quite clearly says that these are Pakistan-backed elements outside Pakistani state. So they are not in the established Pakistani jurisdiction, but Pakistan is propping up elements internationally who are trying to spread the kind of hate and venom and actually fan the fire that they believe is already there inside this country, in which they can find their target very easily and disturb the country's social harmony and amicability of this nation through the established fault lines. That is the whole attempt that the Pakistanis are trying to indulge in. And remember, Navika, Prime Minister's movement is curtailed, but in the house that he lives in should be an unbreachable fortress. Unfortunately, the history does not vouch that. There have been breaches to the Prime Minister's residence, not after Mr. Narendra Modi became the Prime Minister, but certainly in the past. Prime Minister's convoy in this country has been breached. He has travelled. It is not as if that he is completely not travelling. He did travel to Ayodhya. So the intelligence agencies and the security agencies are absolutely in no position to take a chance. And in the history of independent India, it would not be incorrect to say that Prime Minister Narendra Modi probably is one of the few leaders who have faced the kind of threat perception that he is facing even currently. So therefore, agencies not wanting to take any chance have got the assessment done. Multi-agency coordination center at the apex of all intelligence assessment in this country. Union Home Ministry sounding an alert. Special Protection Group guarded only with the job of guarding the personage of the Prime Minister has also done the target hardening exercise. Obviously, even trying to nullify any lone wolf, self-radicalized kind of attack that can come in the wake of such kind of campaigns that are run targeting the Prime Minister himself.
Well, Nikunj, clearly it is an attempt to try and target the Prime Minister at a time when such situations are created in our domestic politics to target the Prime Minister. And it is not something that is echoed across the country, but just in a few pockets. But the resonance and the advantage that is being taken by strike groups abroad, clearly getting their fodder from these kind of groups within India. Thanks, Nikunj, for joining me. And the legitimate question on the News Hour tonight is just one. And this question really looks at our own fault lines. Hate Modi politics, is it something that's inciting these assassins abroad? That's the question. And the hashtag Kill Modi plot letter. That's the debate on the other side.
You're watching the News Hour at 9. Debate number 1 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
And joining me tonight on the News Hour, Gaurav Bhatia, National Spokesperson of the BJP, Dr. Anand Ranganathan, author Savio Rodrick's Chief Editor, Goa Chronicles, Dr. Dinesh Vashne, Leader CPI, Atikur Rahman, Islamic Scholar, Tehsin Poonawala, Political Analyst, Majid Haidri, Political Analyst. But my first question to you, Gaurav Bhatia. Gaurav Bhatia, why is it that a popularly elected Prime Minister is questioned every step of the way? And the kind of statements that are made border on hate at a time when they want to point out that it is hate that is being spewed by the BJP led by the Prime Minister himself. How can they spew so much hate and accuse the Prime Minister of hate? Because the statements that were made in Shaheen Bagh earlier this year clearly said, Hitler ki maut marega, or us katil ka hum kya haal karenge. Gaurav Bhatia, isn't this something that's giving advantage to assassin groups abroad?
Navika, you made a very important agreement here, and I will take it forward. This agreement with the ideology of the BJP, dissent is fine, but incitement is not. That is not part of the freedom of speech, the right guaranteed under the Constitution. But lately we have seen, since the time Narendra Modi ji has been taking historic and landmark courageous decision, that the opposition, in their hate for Narendra Modi ji, has forgotten that it is also their duty to love the country. And that is why I say every human life in our country is important. But yes, the Prime Minister's security is also of prime importance, because he shapes the destiny of 130 crore Indians. And we have seen in the past, I am giving you a few examples, some were cited by you also. On foreign soil, Manish Shankar Iyer goes to Pakistan and says, we also want friendly relations with Pakistan, but remove Narendra Modi. Did Sonia Gandhi utter a word? Did Rahul Gandhi say anything on that? And the saddest part is, let me tell you, that no force can even harm Narendra Modi ji, because 130 crore Indians will collectively stand as the bulletproof jacket of Narendra Modi. So therefore, Pakistan is definitely not happy and doesn't like Narendra Modi. That can be understood. India loves Narendra Modi. But why is it parties like the Congress, the Trinamool, their leaders have started inciting the mob? Shaheen Bagh is a very good example of that. What were small children saying? They were poisoned to say, Narendra Modi ji or Amit Shah ji ko maro. The Prime Minister and Home Minister should be eliminated.
Well,
kids are saying by protesting.
Well, I don't know. Tehsin Poonawalla, what do you find amusing in this letter that has been accessed by NIA on the 8th of August? 8th of August 2020, and since then it's been escalated to various agencies. You seem to be smiling year to year. I want to ask you.
If you receive a letter like this, I will not be happy at all. I will be with my friend, even with all the differences. But he is grinning and smiling as if this is a comedy show. Very sad, Tehsin.
Tehsin,
not expected out of you.
What's so funny about the Prime Minister of our country being on target? What's so funny about it?
I'll be very, very brief. Good evening, man. Namaste. On the 1st of September 2020, at 8:54 a.m., I tweeted that the only way to avoid this fiasco over the -3.9 GDP growth downturn, Hiren Joshi will put out a threat to Prime Minister Modi's story. Hiren Joshi should get more creative. If you permit me to read out the tweet, I can read out the whole tweet.
Why do you want to bring in Hiren Joshi? Is he here to defend himself? And do you think this letter comes out from the Prime Minister's office? This is an NIA letter. And this came on the 8th of August, much before your 1st of September. Absolutely asinine tweet.
Okay, let me answer. I am repeating what I'm saying on Times Now once again. Please tell Prime Minister Modi to get more creative on diverting the attention of this country. This is deja vu.
What diverting
on
attention?
6:22. Please don't interrupt
this.
Nikhil, you didn't see the program, my friend. Please put him on mute. I'm going to finish my topic. I'm very brief. 6:22 on 10th May 2018. Chilling plot to kill Prime Minister Modi. This tweet was by Times Now. It's deja vu. Please, I repeat, ask Hiren Joshi to get slightly more creative.
If
you allow me to read my tweet, the disaster is not that our GDP has fallen to -23.9. The story to watch out for is what will Honorable Supreme Leader do to distract from the disaster. Small distraction, Tharoor Chidambaram. Medium distraction, Daud Pakistan. Large distraction, Modi, life on the threat.
You know, Tehsin Poonawalla, I think you're so knowledgeable, you are a Jyotishi, you are a scientist, you are an intellectual, all rolled into one, and I don't know what the mixture is called. To me, it's called Panchranga Achar, but let me get in Dr. Anand Ranganathan. Dr. Anand Ranganathan, I want to ask you, Mr. Tehsin Poonawalla wants us and wants this country to believe that he knew that this was coming. Would you like to tell him that this letter that we've accessed was a mail that came in on 8th of August at 1:23 a.m. on the website, in fact, on the email ID of the NIA's office in Mumbai. And Mr. Tehsin Poonawalla, know-it-all, has this grin saying, मुझे तो पहले से ही पता था, इन्हें तो पहले से ही पता था कि मोदी जी 2014 में भी जीतेंगे, इन्हें तो पहले से ही पता था कि मोदी जी 2019 में भी जीतेंगे, इन्हें तो पहले से ही पता था कि कांग्रेस पार्टी के प्रेसिडेंट सोनिया गांधी बनेंगी, उनको तो पहले से ही पता था कि सोनिया गांधी के बाद राहुल गांधी बनेंगे कांग्रेस के प्रेसिडेंट. सावियो, any mystery, suspense in what Mr. Tehsin Poonawalla is thinking? All of this he knew.
Well, you know, Navika, Tehsin has a premonition that normally tends to go wrong. You know, there was a time when he thought Rahul Gandhi was worth the Prime Minister of India, but there is no hope of Rahul Gandhi ever becoming the Prime Minister of India, because India is far greater than the stupidity that Rahul Gandhi shows in character and in the talk that he does. But forget Tehsin Poonawalla, he's not important. What is important is the threat to Narendra Modi's life. Why is the threat happening? Because Narendra Modi is actually going about destroying the enemies of India in a very clinical and precise way. And that is what is affecting people not only in India, but people internationally who have an issue with the growth of India. Not everything in India is correct.
Is not growth,
and not everything that BJP is doing is correct. But one thing that Narendra Modi is doing right is he's getting the people across the world and in India to think India. And that is the problem. Most of the anti-nationals in India, most of the people who are against India externally have against Narendra Modi. So is he under threat? He would have been under threat right from the day he became the Prime Minister. So Tehsin, you can smirk all you like. Rahul Gandhi will never become the Prime Minister of India. So you can smirk. It's all
well, right. Dr. Anand Ranganathan, I want to get you in, because Mr. Tehsin Poonawalla wants us all to believe that he knew that this threat is going to come out, because he tweeted this on the 1st of September. Now, I just want to bring to your notice the little detail that Mr. Tehsin Poonawalla, of course, is not interested in, which is that this email came on the 8th of August. So if Mr. Modi knew that the economy was going to decline on the 8th of August, so he got this orchestrated and the email landed into the NIA email inbox on the 8th of August. You know, is this something that is even believable? And for somebody like Mr. Tehsin Poonawalla, who calls himself such a human rights activist that he goes to court at the drop of a hat when anybody is lynched, he actually has a smile and a smirk on his face when there is a threat to the life of the Prime Minister of this country?
Yeah, good evening, Navika. You know, although rebutting Tehsin are the simple pleasures of my life, but I must say that unfortunately it eats into my allotted time. So I request you to give me 30 seconds extra. I will rebut Tehsin and then I will go to the thrust of the thesis that I have on the topic. Now, Tehsin, you know, I'm all for having a jibe, gentle humor and all, but my friend, this today is not the day for two reasons. Number one, what if this threat were actually to come true? For example, a week before Rajiv Gandhi was assassinated, 2 days before Indira Gandhi was assassinated, if there was a threat perception by the security agencies and someone from the BJP had mocked on it like you are doing, and the threat was realized, would you have felt good about it? So it's not right that you do this. And number two, when green laser light from a pen or a mic shone on your great leader Rahul Gandhi, you went ballistic for 2 days saying that the government is ignoring this threat. Some sniper is after the life of Rahul Gandhi. Same guy. So please don't do this. Please don't mock such serious threats. Thank you. Now, Navika, can I return to the topic? Because it's a very serious topic and we were having a very serious discussion before Tehsin came in. You know, I'm sure our security agencies will neutralize the threat like they have done so many times before this. Look, I don't know of any man other than Modi who has been subjected to so much hate for so long. It has, of course, been exacerbated by the two momentous decisions taken by him in the last year, abrogation of 370 and the CAA. So such threats by haters are natural. Of course, they would never succeed because they have never succeeded in breaking up India. It all starts with their pent-up anger and hate at being seen as fanatical rejects of the society, professing a defunct ideology, incapable of winning elections or coming to power, but ever ready to brainwash people into walking on their destructive paths. And when all their hate materializes into a tragedy, their automatons begin the act of rationalizing it with the time-tested means of humanizing the criminal. Maths teacher, son of a headmaster, unemployed teenager, disgruntled Naxal. Remember little kids at Shaheen Bagh calling for the murder of Modi and Shah? Remember how their cries were cheered? Remember the jubilation when Amit Shah was hospitalized with COVID? Remember the mocking and ridiculing of every such threat, including GDP discuss nahi kar rahe to ye aa gaya. So this is nothing new. More worrying, please give me 30 seconds, Navika. More worrying than these threats to the Prime Minister that will easily be neutralized by our competent agencies are the threats received by those who do not have any protection. Remember in January, Bangalore police arrested men who for mere 10,000 each plotted to kill the young BJP MP Tejaswi Surya because of his pro-CA stand. They came to kill him at a rally but couldn't so because of the crowd, so nearly killed an RSS worker instead. Tejaswi was later provided with security, one guard. So that kind of thing is more serious in my opinion and should be taken note of.
Well, I want to ask a very, very pointed question to Mr. Atiqur Rahman. Mr. Atiqur Rahman, repeated hate messages, hate language has been used against the Prime Minister. Starting from Sonia Gandhi's Maut Ke Saudagar in 2007, down to Waris Pathan, down to Mr. Manishankar Iyer. You know, you name them and they've used hate language against the Prime Minister. I want to ask you, Mr. Atiqur Rahman, do you know that minorities have voted for the Prime Minister as well? 37% of the seats dominated by more than 25% of Muslims in those constituencies have been won by the BJP in 2019. Could that have happened if the minorities were completely against Modi? And I want Nizam Bhai to put out those graphics of our election. You know, everybody has seen that Modi's share in the minorities have gone on increasing. 4% Muslims voted for the BJP in 2009. This increased to 9% in 2014 and even higher in 2019. Why do you make this as if the entire community is against the Prime Minister?
That's the more reason, Navika ji. I see not only Muslims, every Indian is duty bound to protect the august institution of our Prime Minister. I don't understand since the you know 6 p.m. onwards why Times Now is only pinpointing Shaheen Bagh and Muslims and the Muslims trying to get the attention of their government to their misery. If, as Gaurav Bhatia ji said just now, pointing out to our misery, you take it as a threat to the Prime Minister, then God save your mind. You are so obsessed with the communal agenda and the hate politics in India that you are pinpointing only the Muslims to have a kill for the Prime Minister. No, Mr. Gaurav Bhatia.
I did not say only Muslims. Since evening, and you were on the show at 6 p.m. as well, I told you there is a lobby that includes some minorities, that includes some so-called liberals, that includes some so-called seculars, that includes some so-called people who think Modi is against freedom of speech, that includes some so-called people who are always calling him Hitler, who doesn't allow basic constitutional freedoms. Isn't that the question at this point in time, Mr. Gaurav Bhatia?
Is China your friend?
You know, let me respond to my learned friend. He seems to be aggrieved, saying that Muslims are being targeted. Navika, nobody is doing that. Neither did you do it, nor did Anandji do it. I never made a statement to that effect. What are we discussing? We are discussing, and you raised a point, Navika, that Muslims have also voted for Narendra Modi ji. But I would slightly make it different. Say 100% Muslims voted for Modi ji or 0% Muslim voted for Modi ji. It makes no difference to the fact that the human life is to be protected, and especially that of the Prime Minister who has been duly elected. Second, you remember the threat was received in the Elgar Parishad incident also. There was a letter that was from Maoist. So it was not about any religious denomination. But a lot of people came out to say there is no threat. It has been concocted. So a valid question would be, which every citizen is asking, when it comes to Narendra Modi ji, why
no
do you people have double standards?
No threat is valid. Absolutely. You hit the nail on the head. And Dinesh Vashne ji, I want to ask you this question. When it comes to Narendra Modi, every threat is said, this is a concocted threat. Mr. Tehsin Poonawalla says, I prophesized on the 1st of September that now the GDP numbers have come out, so soon will come out another bahana. You said the same thing when the Elgar Parishad case came in. Now this has come in, same explanation. Mr. Dinesh Vashne, is the life of every Indian important or not? And is the life of Prime Minister Narendra Modi less important than the lives of the Gandhis or any other Indian in this country? You know, every time a laser pen is shown, you know, there becomes a parliament stalemate just because no security is given and SPG is withdrawn. And when the Prime Minister's threat letter comes out, you question the motives for it.
Look, Navika, who said what? I am not going to comment on that today. But we are of the opinion we don't support the politics of murder or threat of the murder. We do not support, and no political party in India will support. We have full faith in the SPG and SG's commandos that they will be able to protect the Honorable Prime Minister of the country, Modi ji. Earlier also, we have lost two Prime Minister, Indira Gandhi ji and Rajiv Gandhi. So we should be careful. All these type of threats must be dealt seriously.
But isn't the divisive politics within the country giving a handle to the assassins abroad? And this is despite... This is despite recognition that's coming out from abroad. Bahrain has awarded the Prime Minister the King Hamad Order of Renaissance. Also, the Order of Zayed that has been given by Maldives. There has been a Palestine Award that is the rule of Nishan Izzuddin. So many awards have been given. Yet, people within the country will continue to question the Prime Minister.
This is a question that every citizen must be protected, including the migrant labor. Kanhaiya Kumar received hundreds of threats from the RSS and BJP supported leaders. Pinarayi Vijayan received a threat of 5 crore rupees or murder him by a BJP leader in Kerala. See, you condemned all these things. And we should know one thing, that these type of threats always come as and when there is a problem in the nation. And the nation is facing a serious problem, that the fact that 23.9% GDP has gone down, minus.
So Navika, can I come in? This is not about GDP.
So we have to be very careful.
You know, we'll discuss GDP also.
We have to be careful. And
you will be bashed there also, proven wrong.
But at
this is about Prime Minister's life and the high rate perception he faces.
So Hitler ki maut marega. Navika, Arun Jaitley ji was senior to me 3 years. We together fought this, shouted a slogan, Angrez Vice Chancellor, Angrez DC, Angrez Police Commissioner, Jo Hitler ki chaal chalega, wo Hitler ki maut marega. This is a slogan, word over.
Okay, so Hitler ki, so there is a justification, Dr. Anand Ranganathan, a justification coming in from Dinesh Vashne, who's a professor, who's justifying ke Jo Hitler ki chaal chalega, wo Hitler ki maut marega, can be used for the Prime Minister, because this is something that has been used all along, and therefore it should be given the sanctity of public usage. Dr. Anand Ranganathan, this is not hate politics, but they will say that the Prime Minister and the BJP is guilty of hate politics.
Angrez Sonia Gandhi and others, Congress leaders.
No, of course, Navika, and before I come to rebut Mr. Dinesh Vashne, you know, I for the first minute when Tehsin was grinning like a Cheshire cat, I found it amusing. But Tehsin, you must stop this, yaar. Kyun itna muskura rahe ho? Kya gum hai jisko chupa rahe ho? Bhai, 2024 to decide ho gaya, ab 2029 ki chinta abhi se shuru kar di hai. Please, stop grinning, yaar. It's irritating. Please don't do it. It's a very serious topic. Now, Navika, you know, I'm your spoiled for choice. No, should I go after Mr. Atikur Rahman or should I go after Dinesh Vashni? Let me pick up.
What is the personal insult? क्यों इतना मुस्कुरा रहे हो? क्या गम जिसको छुपा रहे हो? Is a song from a film and sung by Jagjit Singh. What's insulting about it?
It's a beautiful song.
It's a beautiful song. Any time of the day, any day of the year, it's a beautiful song. You find this insulting and that grin of yours that should not be found insulting.
I'll answer it. Very briefly, and before I come to you, why I find it insulting is because at minus 23.9% crores of Indians are going to die, and Anand is saying, "Kyun kya gum hai? Gum hai, bhai, because our fellow citizens are dying. 3,000 people are protecting the Prime Minister. He will live a long life.
अरे भाई, अगर इतना ही gum है, तो अपनी 2.5 crore की Patek Philippe watch को बेच के कुछ गरीबों को खाना खिला दो.
My arguments are not hollow like a batura. Tempting but hollow.
You know, Tehsin Poonawala. While I agree that the economy is worrying, but may I tell you? May I tell you that after a lockdown where there was everything shut down, from shops to factories to purchase to everything was shut down. I don't know how many of you thought that we would be plus 25% in GDP. You know, common sense, number one. And number two, जो आदमी आनंद रंगनाथन जो आदमी अनियन की प्राइसेस पे प्रोटेस्ट करने जाता है इंडिया गेट पे रोलेक्स की घड़ी पहन के, वो गरीबों का दर्द बताएगा इस देश को? Anand Ranganathan's making a point.
I support the migrant labor. I support the farmers.
Yeah, minus 23.9%.
Yes, now Professor Vashne, it's a bit rich. You talking about the murder of innocents? Yours was the only party in the world that publicly hailed the Tiananmen Square massacre, in which 10,534 innocents were brutally murdered. They were rolled over by tanks. You hailed it. Aur aap baat kar rahe hain. Now he'll keep on interrupting. But Navika, very quickly, from one ship to the other, let me jump to Mr. Atikur Rahman. Has he ever condemned about those despicable slogans for killing Modi and Shah, paid by now little children in Shaheen Bagh? He hasn't. And he is talking about perpetrating hate. कौन सा hate? आपने 70 साल से दलितों के लिए कश्मीर में कुछ नहीं किया, उनकी rights को brutally trample किया. जब मोदी ने एब्रोगेट किया 370, दलितों को rights मिली, homosexuals को rights मिली. आप उसके अगेंस्ट हैं? आप CA के अगेंस्ट हैं? जबकि कांग्रेस और कम्युनिस्ट वही बिल चाहते थे 2012 में. लेकिन अब मोदी है तो आप उसके अगेंस्ट हैं? और आप कौन से हेट की बात करते हैं? जो आप हर रोज इस्लामिक स्क्रिप्चर पढ़ते हैं, वो कहता है कि हिंदूज i.e. पॉलिथीस आर द वर्स्ट ऑफ क्रीचर्स. पीपल हु डोंट बिलीव इन अवर वर्सेस शैल रोस्ट इन हेल. कौन से हेट की बात कर रहे हैं आप?
Majid Haidri, let me get Majid Haidri into the mix. And Majid Haidri, I want to ask you all the Sabka Saath Sabka Vikas schemes that are run by the Prime Minister. You think Ujwala gas is given to Hindu women, not to Muslim women? Do you think Garib Kalyan Yojana runs for Hindus and not for Dalits and Muslims? Do you think all the schemes under the farm insurance schemes and other schemes that have come, the Jan Dhan Yojana scheme, do these run only for one religion and not for the other? Why is so much of hate? Why is there so much of division in our own country about our own Prime Minister? Maybe you didn't vote for him. You have a choice to dissent. Fair enough. But to say, Katil hai, Maut ka saudagar hai, Hitler ki maut marega, is that fair for any human being? Forget somebody who's the head of the state, the Prime Minister of the country.
Panus ban ke jiski hifazat hawa kare,
वो शम्मा क्या बुझे जिसे रोशन खुदा करे। ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी जी इज द हेड ऑफ द फैमिली ऑफ 1.3 बिलियन मेंबर्स, सो इट्स टेक्निकली एंड मॉरली रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ एवरी मेंबर टू बी कंसर्न अबाउट हिज सेफ्टी, सिक्योरिटी एंड वेलफेयर।
आदाब अर्ज है, आदाब अर्ज है माजिद हैदरी साहब, आज तो मुकर्रर कहने को जी कर रहा है।
नाउ लेट मी हैव द राइट टू क्वेश्चन।
आदाब ने कमाल कर दिया, मुझे डर है कि अमित शाह जी के पास उनकी फाइल तो नहीं पहुंच रही है,
बिकॉज इवन पार्लियामेंट हैज बीन डिप्राइव्ड द राइट ऑफ क्वेश्चन आवर, दैट इज द काइंड ऑफ कंडीशन वी आर फेसिंग।
अरे क्वेश्चन आवर में तो रोज शोर करते हो, सुनना तो चाहते नहीं हो कुछ।
थ्रेट इज बीइंग मिसइंटरप्रेटेड। नो, माय क्वेश्चन टू आनंद रघुनाथन एंड गौरव भाटिया जी इज इफ द थ्रेट इज बीइंग मिसइंटरप्रेटेड, बिकॉज द प्रॉब्लम एट द मोमेंट इज दैट वी हैव अ थ्रेट टू इकोनॉमी, वी हैव लैंडेड इन हेल होल, we have a threat to the Indian territorial integrity in Ladakh, we even have a threat to life of Riya Chakrabarti. I mean, if all these threats are being misinterpreted as being the threat to honorable prime minister, because we need to know, but we don't have the right to ask, because even parliament has been deprived of that right to ask. Anand Raghunathan ji, why don't we have a question hour? Why can't we question? Why can't the democracy question? Why can't we question over the falling GDP?
You want to question? What do you want to question? आप मुझे बताइए माजिद हैदरी साहब, आप क्या क्वेश्चन करना चाहते हैं? आप रिया चक्रवर्ती की सिक्योरिटी क्वेश्चन करना चाहते हैं? सुशांत सिंह राजपूत की सिक्योरिटी तो आपने क्वेश्चन की नहीं, आपने की नहीं सुशांत सिंह राजपूत की सिक्योरिटी। अब आप पार्लियामेंट चाहते हैं, पार्लियामेंट में 1 मिनट, पार्लियामेंट में अब आप क्या क्वेश्चन करना चाहते हैं कि ये जो थ्रेट है ये रियल है कि नहीं? व्हाट इज योर क्वेश्चन?
बिकॉज वी फर्स्टली डोंट ट्रस्ट द एनआईए, इट इज द सेम एनआईए विच गेव अ क्लीन चिट टू दैट वन साध्वी, आई डोंट वांट टू नेम हर, आनंद रघुनाथन जी स्माइलिंग, ही नोज हर बेटर देन मी। NIA, IB, these
no,
all
no, saab, you know, just
you know, this is amazing. This is amazing. Police officers create Hindu terror and beat up Sadhvi or you know, the person you are naming in the jail. That is all right for you, but declaring her as innocent till such time that she is proven guilty by the courts, that's not all right by you. You know, Anand Ranganathan, ye log wahi hai jo media trial bhi question karte hai, chit bhi meri, pat bhi meri, Anand Ranganathan and Gaurav Bhatia. Anand Ranganathan first.
No, of course. No, Navika, I will take more than 10 seconds because that amount of time is enough to demolish Mr. Hadri's logic. No, 1 second, Majid Hadri saab, please, wait, sunne ki shamta rakhi. You know, he is saying that we can't believe in any Indian institutions because they're all run quote-unquote by Modi. So, NIA ko inhone vishwas chhod diya. But ek institution pe aaj inko bada vishwas hai, jo GDP ki value leke aaya hai. Wo nahi keh rahe ki ye GDP value nakli hai. Kyon bhai?
Gaurav Bhatia.
आप गैरों की बात करते हैं, हमने अपने भी आजमाए हैं, लोग कांटों से बच के चलते हैं, हमने फूलों से जख्म खाए हैं। तो मोदी जी जिन नागरिकों को फूल समझते हैं वो भी कई बार जख्म दे देते हैं। नाउ द बेसिक क्वेश्चन टुडे इज नाविका, द वर्थ ऑफ अ ह्यूमन लाइफ, it could be anybody, Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai, it could be North Indian, South Indian, Kashmiri, Prime Minister, constitutional position holder or not holder. But how is it that these people feel that life of Afzal Guru, who was convicted, is a judicial killing, but Aurangzeb's life or Narendra Modi ji's life or Ayub Pandit's life is not important? That is the kind of hypocrisy we are questioning. And let me say this, the security intelligence agencies, the NIA, are doing their job, but when soothsayers come on your program, वो मुस्कुरा इसलिए नहीं रहे हैं कि उनको कोई गम है, वो इसलिए मुस्कुरा रहे हैं कि उनमें अकल कम है। उनको ये नहीं पता जब कोई गंभीर मसला हो तो मुस्कुराया नहीं जाता है, आर्ग्यूमेंट दिए जाते हैं और आर्ग्यूमेंट देने के बाद व्यूअर्स को कन्विंस कर दिया जाता है कि ये डाइवर्ट करने की टैक्टिक है।
Well, Gaurav Bhatia is in devastating form tonight, and ladies and gentlemen, it's not a laughing matter. It is a serious issue. The issue is, we don't wish bad for anybody. But when it is the Prime Minister of the country who's on target, and possibly because of the hate politics and the divisions that we display, कहा जाता है ना कि अगर घर का भेदी ही हो जो लंका ढाता है, अगर हम अलग अलग रहेंगे तो ये रहेगी, बंद हो मुट्ठी तो लाख की, खुल गई तो बिन खाक की. All Indians need to respect institutions and people who represent not just themselves, but the position that they hold. That is something that we should not allow any enemy country to take advantage of. And that is the only basic truth. At a time when the Prime Minister is facing this threat, agencies are well versed in the SOPs in protecting him. But if Indians come together, it just makes it better for others to look at a united country. Thank you very much to my panelists for joining me on debate number one. We'll take a